أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أمسينا وأمسى الملك لله والحمد لله لا شريك له لا إله إلا هو وإليه المصير أمسينا على فطرة الإسلام وكلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى ملة أبينا إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين اللهم إني أمسيت منك في نعمة وعافية وستر فأتم علي نعمتك وعافيتك وسترك في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم ما أمسى بي من نعمة أو بأحد من خلقك فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك فلك الحمد ولك الشكر يا رب لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا ثم أما بعد My dear respected brothers and sisters السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته We start our halaqa tonight by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him for everything. And by sending our salam, our prayers upon our last and final prophet, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the time we are spending together tonight, far away from one another, but our hearts are together. I have no doubt. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us together all the time. Ameen. My dear brothers and sisters, before I start the reminder, tonight, a few days ago, I talked about the importance of dhikr, dhikrullah azza wa jal. And I have started, as I start every time, by repeating and mentioning some of the adhkar that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say every morning and every evening. Like amsayna wa amsa al-mulku lillah. In the morning we say asbahna wa asbaha al-mulku lillah. And one of the adhkar that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to say, very important all the time, especially now, is to say three times in the morning and three times in the evening. Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma'asmihi shay' fil ardi wa la fis sama' wa huwa as-sami'u al-alim. Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma'asmihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama' wa huwa as-sami'u al-alim. Let's say it all together. Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma'asmihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis sama' wa huwa as-sami'u al-alim. The Prophet ﷺ said that whoever says this dua every day, three times in the morning, three times in the evening, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing will harm him or her. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us safe and protect us all the time. So as I have mentioned earlier today in the khutbah, Jumu'ah, I talked about the significance, I talked about the importance, the power of ad-du'a. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Ad-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah." Ad-du'a is the worship. It doesn't mean that there is nothing else to do to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it means that ad-du'a is a very important act of worship that we should never neglect, we should never ignore. We should always turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, raise our hands and ask Him for whatever we want in this life and the hereafter. And now I would like to go through some of the manners and the etiquette of ad-du'a. Adab ad-du'a. There are some things that we need to pay attention to, some things that we need to observe to make sure that we are making dua in the right way, and our dua will be answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, تحري أوقات الاستجابة, which means to seek the blessed times. Make sure to know when are the blessed times, so we increase in making dua during these times. Of course, we can make dua anytime we want. And the dua by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is answered and accepted anytime, as long as it comes from the bottom of our hearts, it comes from a pure heart. But when we make the dua during those specific blessed times, it means that for sure a dua will be accepted, inshallah. And some of these times, like the day of Arafah, the ninth day of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Arafah, whether we are standing in Arafah or we are wherever on this earth, the day itself is a blessed day. Shahru Ramadan, the holy month of Ramadan, it's coming soon. It's one of the most blessed times of the year. We should always remember to make a lot of dua in Ramadan, especially while fasting. Yawm al-Jumu'ah, like today, the Friday, making dua Yawm al-Jumu'ah. And this is according to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that there is a time on Friday, on a Jumu'ah. There is a time whenever a person is making dua, during that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer the dua. What's that time on Friday? We don't know. Some scholars, they said during Salat al-Jumu'ah, some scholars, they said between Asr and Maghrib of Yawm al-Jumu'ah, of the Friday. We don't know. That's why we need to make dua at all time during the day of al-Jumu'ah. Waqtu al-Sahar, the last part of the night, the last third of the night. And we know this according to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come down and will come down according to His majesty, to His glory. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask, is there anyone seeking forgiveness, so I will forgive him or her? Anyone asking and making dua, so I will answer their dua? It's a blessed time. Between adhan and iqamah, also it is a blessed time that we need to take advantage of. Make sure between adhan and iqamah. Unfortunately, many of us, when we are in the masjid between adhan and iqamah, and we are sitting in the masjid waiting for the iqamah, we engage in, you know, whatever type of conversation, and sometimes even saying jokes. And we shouldn't do this. Between adhan and iqamah is a very precious time. We should take advantage of that time to make dhikr, to make istighfar, to make dua. It's a blessed time. Athna al-safar, while traveling, also, it's a blessed time, and we need to also make dua on the road when we travel. When it's raining, athna nuzul al-matar, when it's raining, also it's a blessed time. During times of fitna and calamity, as you know, the time we are going through at this moment, it is also a time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the dua. So tahri awqat al-ijaba, seeking the blessed times to make dua, is very important. Number two, the second etiquette of a dua, my dear brothers and sisters, is istiqbalu al-qibla wa raf'u al-yadayni 'inda al-dua, to face al-qibla. It's not a requirement. It's not a requirement. But it is adab, a manner, an etiquette. As long as we can face al-qibla and make dua, it's better to face al-qibla and make dua. But if you are making dua without facing al-qibla, then that's fine. That's fine. You are not doing something wrong. You are not committing haram. But it's better to face al-qibla, make dua, and raising our hands like this. The Prophet ﷺ, it was reported that sometimes he raised his hands as high as he could, as high as he could. And raising our hands while making dua is a symbol, it's an indication, it's an act of humbleness and humility before Almighty Allah. Number three, عدم التكلف في السجع, which means Do not try to make your dua rhyme with beautiful words and all that stuff. No. The most important dua is the one that comes from the bottom of the heart of the person. Once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was making tawaf around al-Kaaba, and he saw somebody making dua, sitting next to al-Kaaba and making dua. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam approached him and he asked him, "What are you saying in your dua? What are you saying in your dua?" So this man, when he saw the Prophet ﷺ, he felt shy, embarrassed, and he told him, "Ya Rasulullah, inni la a'rifu dandanataka wa dandanata Abi Bakr," which means, "I don't know how to make that beautiful dua, that rhyme, the way you do it, the way Abu Bakr do it. I don't know how to do that." Then the Prophet ﷺ asked him, "Ya akhi, I'm just asking you, what are you saying in your dua?" He said, "The only thing that I'm saying in the dua, the only thing I know to say is, Allahumma arzuqni al-jannah wa qini adhab an-nar. Oh Allah, grant me heaven, paradise, al-jannah, and save me from the hellfire." Then the Prophet ﷺ told him, "Wa hawlaha nudandin," which means that all that beautiful dua that rhyme with the beautiful words, all of it, the bottom line of it, is what you are saying. Is what you are saying. So my brothers and sisters, don't care a lot about the beautiful dua and selecting the beautiful words that rhyme. Just make dua with the words that you know, with the language that you know, in one condition that comes from the bottom of your heart. You know what you are saying. You mean what you say. And you understand the dua that you are making to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number four, خَفْضُ الصَّوْتِ عِنْدَ الدُّعَاء, to lower your voice when you make dua. You don't have to scream. You don't have to scream so everybody knows what you are saying. Just lower your voice and do it with sincerity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about Prophet Zakariya alayhi salam, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا. When Zakariya made dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made it with a lower voice. إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا. خَفِيًّا, which means almost silently, just between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I mentioned earlier in the khutbah, the verse from Al-Quran Al-Kareem, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. And when my servants ask you about me, I am near to them. I am near. And this verse was revealed to the Prophet ﷺ when some sahaba, some companions came to him and they asked him, "Ya Rasulullah, أَقَرِيبٌ رَبُّنَا فَنُنَاجِيهِ أَمْ بَعِيدٌ فَنُنَادِيهِ. Is our Lord near to us so we can supplicate to him, make dua to him with a lower voice? Or is he far away, so we have to scream, we have to make dua with a loud voice?" Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down this verse to the Prophet ﷺ to tell him, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I am near to them. So one of the adab, one of the etiquette of making dua is to lower our voice while making this dua. Number five, افْتِتَاحُ الدُّعَاءِ بِالثَّنَاءِ عَلَى اللَّهِ وختمه بالصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Always, my brothers and sisters, when you make dua, at the beginning always, الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله, or بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We start by praising Allah عز وجل and sending salat and salam on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And when we finish, also, don't forget to send the prayers and the salam upon the Prophet ﷺ, either by saying, Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wa salamun ala al-mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, or wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim tasliman kathira. Any term, any sentence, any words that indicate that we are sending prayers and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It was reported in the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, كل دعاء محجوب حتى يصلى على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Every dua that we make, every dua does not reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until we make salam and salat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number six, istiqamatul batin. And this is something very important, which means to make sure that we are pure internally, pure inside of us. We are straightforward on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-taharatu wa an-naqa'u al-batini. We have to make sure that internally we are doing good. How can we do that? Number one, tajdeedu at-tawbah. To renew the tawbah, the repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek his forgiveness more than 80 times a day and sometimes 100 times a day. إِنِّي لَأَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِي الْيَوْمِ مِئَةَ مَرَّةٍ. This is how he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, that I repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day 100 times. Why? What did he do wrong to do that? Nothing. But this is something that we do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We renew our tawbah because we never know what we have done wrong. We never know what we have said wrong. So every time before we make dua, we renew our tawbah, our repentance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَدُّ الْمَظَالِمِ. If we have taken something unlawfully, wrongly from people before making dua, make sure to give back this stuff to the people. Everything that you have done wrong with people, whether physical abuse or verbal abuse, seek forgiveness from people before you seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is something very important. Sometimes we do horrible stuff, horrible things with people. We abuse them. We do horrible things. And then we turn to Allah, Ya Allah, aghfirli. Ya Allah, forgive me. What does that mean? We need to fix our relationship with people and then turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek for his forgiveness. Tatyibul mat'am. Tatyibul mat'am, which means to make sure that everything we have, everything we eat, everything we wear, everything we use in our lives comes from a halal way, comes from a lawful way. Tatyibul mat'am, tatyibul malbas, tatyibul mashram, al-mashram. Whatever we eat, whatever we drink, whatever we wear, whatever we use comes from a lawful way, from halal way. There's a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. ثُمَّ ذَكَرَ الرَّجُلَ أَشْعَثَ أَغْبَرَ يُطِيلُ السَّفَرَ يَرْفَعُ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ يَا رَبْ يَا رَبْ وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامٌ وَمَشْرَبُهُ حَرَامٌ وَغُذِّيَ بِالْحَرَامِ فَأَنَّى يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. The Prophet ﷺ is talking about a person who raised his hands high, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dua, but whatever he eats comes from haram, whatever he wears comes from haram, whatever he drinks comes from haram. فَأَنَّ يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. How come this person, the dua that he makes will be accepted? So تَطْيِيبُ الْمَطْعَمِ is very important. تَطْيِيبُ الْمَلْبَسِ is very important. The other hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إن اللقمة الحرام إذا دخلت جوف أحدكم لا يتقبل عمله 40 يوما. The bite of food earned from al-haram, whenever it goes inside, eaten by the person for 40 days, the dua and the ibadah from this person will not be accepted. Will not be accepted. It's very important to make sure, my dear brothers and sisters, before asking why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not accepting my dua, I have to ask myself, do I earn everything I have, everything I use, I eat, I wear, I drink, from halal or from haram? This is very important. Number seven, at-tayaqqunu min al-ijabah. Ud'u Allah wa antum muqinoon bil-ijabah. Which means when we make dua, we shouldn't make dua and have that doubt. I don't know whether Allah is going to forgive me or not. I don't know. I mean, I'm just making dua and, you know, it's up to him. No. When you make dua, be sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua. Ud'u Allah. make dua wa antum muqinun bil ijaba, while being sure, certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, ud'u Allah wa antum muqinun bil ijaba wa'lamu anna Allah la yastajibu du'aan min qalbin ghafilin lahin. Wa'lamu, and know, keep in mind, that Allah will not accept the dua that comes from a heart that doesn't mean what this person say. Qalb ghafil. Because subhanAllah, sometimes we make dua, you know, and we just, this dua comes from our mouth. We don't mean what we say. We just memorize some terms of dua and we just say them, and we don't even pay attention to what we are saying. This is not the way we are supposed to make dua. We are supposed to make dua, and not only our tongue, our lips move when we say that dua, but also it comes from the bottom of our hearts. Also the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إِذَا دَعَا أَحَدُكُمْ فَلَا يَقُلْ أَلَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي إِنْ شِئْتْ. When one of you makes dua, shouldn't say, oh Allah, forgive me if you want. No. We say, Allahumma ghfir li. And this is an indication that we are sure that Allah will forgive us. We shouldn't say in shi'at. And by the way, one of the mistakes that we do, unfortunately, all the time when we make dua, we say, Allahumma ghfir lana insha'Allah. Allahumma tub alayna insha'Allah. Allahumma shfina wa afina insha'Allah. We're not supposed to say insha'Allah, by the way. I know that sometimes we just say it, you know, without paying attention, but we're not supposed to say insha'Allah in the dua. We just say, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever we want. Allahumma ghfir lana, Allahumma tub alayna, Allahumma ahfadna, Allahumma shfina wa afina, etc. Without saying insha'Allah after that. The other etiquette of a salah, adab, an yulihha fi du'a wa yukarrir thalathan, which means to insist and persist in the du'a, and to repeat the same du'a three times, as Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu said, kana alayhi salam idha da'a du'aan, idha da'a da'a thalathan wa idha sa'ala sa'ala thalathan. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he makes du'a, he used to repeat that du'a three times. Allahumma ghfir lana, اللهم اغفر لنا اللهم اغفر لنا اللهم ارحمنا اللهم ارحمنا اللهم ارحمنا. So to insist on the dua and to repeat the dua three times. وفي صحيح مسلم عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما زال يهتف بربه مادا يديه مستقبل القبلة حتى سقط رداؤه عن منكبيه. Here is Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu describing one of the times when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making dua, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, you know, insisting in the dua, repeating the dua, and he was raising high his hands and his arms to the point that al-rida, which is the cloth that usually men put on their shoulders, fell down from the shoulders, out of the shoulders of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this indicates how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to insist on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while making the dua. Number nine, the ninth adab of a dua, an yu'azzima al-mas'alah. An yu'azzima al-mas'alah, which means to give importance to what you are asking, and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something big, for something great. يعظم المسألة. According to the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذا تمنى أحدكم فليكثر فإنما يسأل ربه. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, you know, as much as you can, for whatever you can, because you are asking the Lord, Allah. You are asking the owner of the heavens and the earth and this universe. You're not asking someone who owns something small. Or no, you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who owns everything. So go ahead and ask for whatever you want. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, wasalu Allah min fadlih, fadlullahi azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, owns everything. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever you want. وَاسْأَلِ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ بِخَيْرَيْ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't only ask Him for things of this dunya, of this worldly life, but ask for this dunya and akhirah. And it is always preferable for the dua to be comprehensive. And we have some examples of comprehensive dua in the Quran. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. This is a beautiful dua that we should always say after each salat. Whenever we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should make this dua that includes everything good in this life and everything good in the afterlife. In Sahih al-Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ said, فَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. Al-Firdaus, whenever you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask Him for Al-Firdaus. Al-Firdaus is the highest stage, the highest place in Al-Jannah, where the Prophets and the Messengers and the Shuhada and the righteous people are. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be with them. Don't say that, oh, I don't know whether I deserve it or not. No, don't say this. Don't say that, I only wish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prevent me from going to hell. After that, I don't care wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put me. No, don't say this. Dream big and ask for something great. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua. فَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make your home in al-Firdaus. And the last etiquette that I would like to share with you today is al-ijtihadu fil ityani bil ad'iyati al-waridati fil Qur'ani wa sunnah, as much as possible to memorize the dua that is mentioned in the Qur'an and in the sunnah, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There are a lot of beautiful dua in the Qur'an, and mostly these are the dua said by the prophets themselves. Said by the prophets themselves. Go to the Quran or Google just al-ad'iya al-warida fil Quran, the dua that is included in the Quran, and you will have all of them. And the dua said by the Prophet ﷺ, try to memorize as much as possible this dua. Use the dua that Allah mentioned in the Quran and the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in the hadith. So these are, my dear brothers and sisters, some of the etiquette, adab, ad-dua, hopefully, inshallah, we should do our best to stick to this ad'iyah, to remember this ad'iyah, this adab, and whenever we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always we should keep in mind and remember these adab, so our dua will be answered. At the end of this reminder, my dear brothers and sisters, let me just go through some of the updates that I have mentioned yesterday and earlier today at Salat al-Jum'ah. And for those who didn't watch Khutbat al-Jum'ah, we made an appeal. And I would like to remind myself and everyone. Now at ICSD, since we are closed, there is a very important project that we are about to start, which is to renew and doing some maintenance work to replace the pipes of the sewer system here. For those who usually come to ICSD, you have noticed in the last few months we had problems. Sometimes we just close the wudu area because the pipes are too old. And, you know, we just got an estimate to replace all the pipes, and this is the best time to do it. And some people, sorry, I forgot to mention the cost of this. So the cost is about $60,000. It's about $60,000. And we started collecting donations in order to cover the expenses of this project that we are going to start in the next few days. So due to the age and high usage of the sewer infrastructure of ICSD building, it is required to make some repairs to maintain and ensure that the system will continue to work and provide a sanitary environment for all. The current system is cast iron, which throughout the years disintegrated from corrosion and buildup that occurs throughout the years. There will be multiple locations that will need to be dug up, as the sewer pipe has been completely tarnished and will need new pieces of pipe in order to for the liner to properly take itself take its from its form. This work is very crucial at this time to avoid major damage in the near future. So please do your best, inshallah. I'm making this appeal to help us cover the expenses of this project that we want to finish as soon as possible. It's very important to do this. And already some brothers and sisters from the community, jazakumullah khair, right after they have heard this appeal during the khutbah of Al-Jumu'ah earlier today, they started donating online and they started sending their checks, mashallah, jazakumullah khair. May Allah bless you, may Allah reward you for whatever you are donating and giving fi sabilillah to maintain al-masjid, to maintain the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I would like to remind you that you can donate online, and we have already posted the link on our website, icsd.org, as well as our Facebook page, ICSD Facebook page. And also for those who are included in the WhatsApp group of ICSD, they have already received the link. So please do your best as soon as possible to support this project, inshallah. Also, we made an announcement about the 2020 census. It's very important. We have talked about it before. You are going to receive the forms to fill up the census form. So as soon as you receive them, please fill out the form and send it back. If you need help, if you need assistance in filling up the census form application, please contact us here at ICSD, and there are people who will help you doing that, inshallah. You know the phone number of the office, 858-278-5240. Or you can email us at admin@icsd.org. And also, ICSD will remain closed for the whole month of April, which includes the start of Ramadan. Again, this decision is based on the instructions and obligatory orders from the federal, state, county, and city authorities. In the next few days, inshallah, we will inform you of the upcoming Ramadan virtual program. There are some brothers and sisters who already called ICSD. They called the office asking what are they going to do in Ramadan. Since we are not going to have any program here, like iftar or taraweeh or something like this. So what are we going to do? Don't worry, inshallah, in the next few days, we are going to share with you some information, some tips, some advices, so you can maintain the spiritual program and the spiritual atmosphere at home, inshallah, throughout the days and the nights of Ramadan. So we will share a lot of information with you, inshallah. Again, if you have any question, you can contact us anytime, either calling the office or emailing us, and we will be more than happy to help you, assist you with whatever we can, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير بارك الله فيكم حفظكم الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us safe. May Allah bless us, all our family members, loved ones, brothers and sisters all over the world. May Allah keep the whole world safe and protected. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us everything good we have done and forgive us for our mistakes and shortcomings. Ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama taslima kathira. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.